Hello and welcome to this overview of SMARTUpdate 8. In the next few minutes, I will show you how SMARTUpdate can significantly improve the quality of your CAD data almost automatically. First of all, we will take a look at updating old models. Then I will show you the configuration tool, and last but not least, you will see the batch mode within a virtual environment. Let's open an assembly so I can show you the updating process. When I switch to the Layers tab, you can see that this is quite chaotic. And when we check the View Manager, you will see that there is not much going on. We lack views, orientations, layer states, and combined states. The same is the case for most of the subcomponents. When clicking Check Model, only the assembly will be checked. To check the complete assembly with all its subcomponents, click Load Subcomponents. As you can see in the dialog, there are lots of issues with the subcomponents as well. To fix all these issues, just hit the update button and SMARTUpdate will do the job for you. Once the work is done, SMARTUpdate rechecks the complete assembly to verify that everything was fixed successfully. The green checkmark indicates that all went well. And if we take a look again, you can see that everything is now up to date. Layers look good. Orientations, layer states, and combined states have been created. Next, we will take a look on how you can set up the rules to instruct SMARTUpdate to fix the models. You can set up any rule in SMARTUpdate by using the configurator. You can create groups to hold the rules like parameters, layers, and so on. Enter names for the groups so the output for the check model dialog is easy to understand. Basically, you can create each rule one by one and set up any details for it. For example, we create a parameter called department of type string. But there is also an easier way to do this. We can use the import function to copy over the elements from our start model. This saves you a lot of time and also makes it easy to update the configuration if the start model should change in the future. To do so, simply hit right mouse button on the parameter folder and select Checks from Model. Now you have to specify a template model. In this case, I will use my start model. Next, you can specify the check type you want to import. We choose parameter. And now we can just check the parameters we want to import and hit OK. It is also possible to filter the elements by typing into the filter panel. You could also define whether you want to create or remove the parameter and hit OK when you are finished. As you can see, the specified check type is now imported into the parameters folder. I will quickly import the other elements of the start model. As you can see, it is a really simple task to create all requirements of your SMARTUpdate configuration. After we set this up for the part mode, we can also copy over all elements to the assembly mode. As our layer concept is based on rules, we should also regenerate the assembly after the update in order to apply the rules. For this task, we will create a map key check that will be triggered once the update process is complete. Another tweak is the removal of unneeded orientations from the parts. To do this, we create an orientation check with the action remove, and we set up a wildcard for the name. Then we move this check at the beginning to remove all existing orientations first and then create the new ones. Then we also copy this check over to the assembly mode. Next, I want to show you the batch mode. With this functionality, you can update a large amount of models. In this example, we will even do this within a windshield environment. To do so, you will have to add the required models to your workspace and check them out. Then you start the batch update model functionality and browse to your workspace. You will now see all models from the workspace in the dialog. As there are also some released standard parts in this assembly, we should exclude them from the update process. SmartUpdate will also make your life easy on this. You can simply add a filter that will exclude all those standard parts. So we add a filter of type parameter called PTCWM lifecycle state with the value released. Now simply select the filter and hit OK. The list is now a bit shorter as the released parts have been removed. And now we can select all the remaining models in the list and click Update. All models will be opened, fixed and saved. At the end, the program shows you the result log, which allows you to check if everything went well. In the workspace, you can see that the files have been modified and can be checked in again. You also see that no released parts have been touched. To sum this video up, with SmartUpdate you can update your outdated models with just a few mouse clicks. Define an extensive set of rules with the powerful configuration tool. Run a batch mode that will fix a large amount of models automatically. And stop wasting time on manually fixing outdated models and spend more time on your project. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, just contact us. Thanks for watching.